nothing like seeing World Championship Wrestling action live. And fans in Fairfax, Virginia, will have that opportunity tonight in just over an hour. WCW Arena event is headed to the Patriot Center. Tomorrow night, WCW action live in Erie, Pennsylvania, at the Civic Center. Now, tickets for both Fairfax, Virginia, and Erie, Pennsylvania, are available at the arena box offices as well as Ticketmaster outlets.
What a night it was last night at the arena in Baltimore. They were rocking the Inner Harbor for World Championship Wrestling, as they always do in Baltimore. It's Bo Payne and Mike Enos on Saturday night.
It's great to watch WCW right here on the Superstation, Monday Nitro on TNT. But Scott, you're right, there is nothing like experiencing WCW action up close and personal.
Bo Payne and Mike Enos, a couple of ring veterans, going to go at it here on Saturday night. You got to wonder if Bo Payne wearing that, whatever that is, around his neck, that's just a weapon. That's just a handle for somebody with the capabilities of Mike Enos to grab that thing and sling him around the ring.
And you know that Mike Enos, as experienced as he is, he's not going to be afraid to take advantage of that. Oh, Bo Payne gets off the first blow. Mike Enos blocks him and turns him around in the corner.
Mike Enos now. One kicks into the gut, shoots Bo Payne across. Oh, caught him right in the gut one more time. Belly to belly, release suplex. Oh, Enos looking tough tonight.
Mike Enos has spent the majority of his career as a tag team wrestler. But as of late here in World Championship Wrestling, he's been going it alone as a single and has had quite a bit of success.
Well, speaking of going it alone after being a tag team wrestler, Rick and Scott Steiner are going at it alone, and they're going to go at it one-on-one at Halloween Havoc on October 25th. The Battle of the Brothers. Big Papa Pump will no doubt have Buff Bagwell in his corner taking on the Dog-Faced Gremlin.
And this is a rematch that I think everybody wants to see, and the WCW Executive Committee has really done the right thing by adding the stipulation that it's going to be a no disqualification match. Power slam by Enos connects on Bo Payne.
What I worry about, Mike Tenay, is something you and Tony Schiavone talked about two nights ago on Thunder, and that is, if Buff Bagwell ever suffers another injury, no one's going to believe it. It's a cliche to talk about the boy who cried wolf, but Buff has cried wolf many times too many. I feel very sorry for Buff if he gets hurt again.
Well, just too many times, and it's impossible at this point for us as announcers to really have any sympathy after what we've witnessed over the course of the past couple of weeks involving Buff Bagwell and Big Papa Pump Scott Steiner.
Well, I will admit, and this is how cynical I guess I've become, Mike Tenay. Last Monday night in Boston, I'm backstage watching the competition, and I saw the injury suffered by Viano 4, at the hands of Raven and Canyon. And the first thing I thought about was, well, he's just taking a page out of Buff Bagwell's book. He wasn't. Viano 4 seriously injured at the hands of Raven and Canyon. He's going to be okay.
Amazing.
But that's what Buff Bagwell has done to this great sport.
Really has. It makes you just look at it with a questioning eye. What a recovery by Viano 4. We understand that he's going to be back in action within a week or so.
Wow.
And he was hospitalized, and the doctors mentioned that because of the thickness of his well-muscled neck, he was able to avoid a very serious injury.
That was a dangerous situation, as was that. Boy, Bo Payne might have taken the worst of that one as Mike Enos sidestepped it just enough.
Almost as if on cue, we're talking about the Luchadors, and Bo Payne connects with the suicide dive on Mike Enos.
Well, Bo Payne has it back together. Mike Enos out at the ringside area. Bo Payne.
Look at him walk the ropes.
Oh, and Enos out of the way, and Bo Payne hit hard. That padding doesn't have an awful lot of padding, if you will.
He crashed and burned on the floor.
Oh, Payne's injured, I think. No, now he's back up on his knees. And Mike Enos sets up Bo Payne, going to shoot him. No, reversal by Enos. And Payne, oh, did he hit the pole.
Shoulder first into the steel, and then a backdrop suplex on the floor by Enos.
I'll be surprised if Bo Payne can muster it up to get back in the ring for this one. Mike Enos, oh, is he looking strong tonight.
WCW senior official Nick Patrick gets in his face, warning him, but Mike Enos is going to hear none of that. Back out to the floor, rolls Bull Payne back into the ring.
I think Enos has cost himself a sure victory right there. I don't think Bull Payne had it in him to come back in the ring, but now throttles Enos across that top steel table.
Maybe just that one burst of adrenaline. That rush by Bull Payne allowed him to drop Enos neck first across the top rope.
But it was enough. Enos is down. Now Bull Payne on the second rope. Walking the ropes again.
Great agility.
And he missed again.
Yeah, great agility, but his aim is not so good.
Maybe his eyesight isn't quite there either. He didn't see Mike Enos roll out of the way. Enos shoots Bull Payne in. Nice float out by Bull Payne, but Enos caught him. Enos caught him. Shoulder high.
Where's he going to take him from here?
Oh, Bull Payne is in a bad, bad way.
Going to whirly bird him.
Into the face first slam, and Mike Enos, this could do it. Lateral press, hooks the leg, cover, two and three.
Well, Mike Enos is now a singles competitor in WCW, but nonetheless, he's put together quite a winning streak.
WCW and